Okay, so we just experienced a pretty common deli scam where they take you to a department store called Deli Hot, as opposed to the actual market, which is called Dilly Hot, spelled D-I-L-L-I. And they obviously get a cut from whatever you buy in that store. So now you know.
When you say culture shock, chaos, and scams, the first thing you might think of is India. But the country is also home to some of the friendliest people in the world, killer street food, and stunning monuments. There's so much to unpack when it comes to India, but before you go, you're gonna need to know a couple of things. Here are 11 things not to do in India. Number 1. Taxi scams. This is probably the first thing that you'll run into while in India. And the way it works is you land at the airport, hop in a cab, and tell him your destination. At which point he tells you that the place you're going to is closed, relocated, or, and I swear I'm not making this up, one time a taxi driver told me that my hotel had burned down. And of course, all of this is done to get you to go to a different hotel or a different place. In which the driver will get a small percentage of whatever you buy there. Basically a finder's fee. The easiest way to avoid this is just to use Uber. That way you know you're getting the best price and the safest ride. Number 2. Pick a hand. Now this is a common misconception, and many people will tell you not to use your left hand while in India to do almost anything. Now this is actually only partly true. A better way of putting it is not to use both hands for everything. That's because most Indians don't use tissues or toilet paper in the bathroom. And, well, you get the idea. Now, as a foreigner, that may not matter when you're visiting. If you want to be culturally correct, just pick one hand and use that. For example, if you're right-handed, only use your right hand to pick up food. Or if you're left-handed, only use your left hand to pick up food. There are thousands of left-handed people in India, so I always find it funny when people say don't use your left hand. Number 3. Don't drink the water. Now this is probably the most obvious and probably the most important rule. Almost nowhere is drinking tap water safe in India, and you should only be drinking bottled water while you're there. Now typically the water quality is so bad that you even have to look out for eating fresh vegetables that have been washed using the water. So when it comes to street food especially, only eat things that you know have been cooked. Number 4. Don't disrespect the cow. The cow is sacred in Hinduism, and millions of Hindus worship the cow as a goddess. Therefore, the cow is considered a sacred animal, as it provides them life by continuously providing milk. Because of that, beef is not incorporated into the Indian diet at all. And if a cow walks into the middle of the street and blocks all of the traffic, no one will touch it. They'll either wait for it to move or politely try and move around it. It's actually kind of hilarious to watch. So if you see one, and you likely will, try and be as respectful as possible. Number 5. Count your change. Now this may seem obvious to some of you, but I've run into my fair share of travelers who have a problem with this. And that's since they assume it's a government-run organization, they'll automatically be given back the right amount of change. Which is definitely not true in India. For example, when I was visiting Humayun's tomb, which is one of the main attractions in Delhi, the ticket office gave me back 100 less rupees than I should have gotten. And when I noticed and went back to tell them, they didn't even look twice and just gave me another 100 rupees. They didn't even care that I caught them lying. It was just business as usual for them.
We've moved on from cricket, now we're trying to figure out how these exercise machines work.
This one raises some questions.
Alright, you give it a shot.
Number 6. Don't be polite. Given that India is a country home to almost 1.3 billion people, personal space doesn't really exist there. And so because of that, you'll find yourself getting pushed around in crowds. Don't take it as an insult or aggressive behavior, it's just their way of doing things. Oh, and you can forget about people lining up in a queue. It's more of a you snooze, you lose mentality.
Number 7. Don't talk politics. India is one of the most diverse countries in the world, with over 720 different dialects.
With so many different cultural nuances, languages, and ideologies, politics can be a tricky subject in India, and you'll find that people will become very animated if you bring it up. In the interest of not offending anyone, I'd recommend maybe toning back the political talk. Even more so when it comes to religion.
So we're not allowed to have beer in this restaurant because they don't have a liquor license, so we're going to hide it in these cups.
Number 8. Proper greetings. Now, I can say without a doubt that when you go to India, you will meet someone there. And it's important to properly know how to greet them. Generally, instead of shaking hands, people place their hands together flat against their chest and say namaste. Furthermore, men do not shake hands or touch women when greeting them. Indian men will sometimes shake hands, and women will sometimes shake hands with Western women, but there's never a crossover between the two. Number 9. Don't point with your feet. In Indian culture, the foot is the lowest part of the body, both literally and symbolically. That means that using your foot to point to anything is considered rude and disrespectful. And even though you probably won't run into that situation when you're traveling, it's still important to know. Number 10. Avoid revealing clothing. In 2016, India's culture and tourism minister said that female tourists visiting the country should not wear skirts or other revealing clothes in order to ensure their safety. Now, of course, because he's the tourism minister, his comments are going to be more conservative. But given the relationship between men and women in India, foreign women traveling there should leave their revealing outfits at home in order to not attract unwanted attention.
Okay, so we run into a slight glitch. We lost our driver, Ricky. Ricky's gone. His car's here.
Maybe he lost his car.
And he can't leave without the car, so...
We're just gonna wait here. For hopefully not too long.
Close call.
So guys, that's it for the video. If you stuck around to the end, thank you. It means a lot. Go ahead and click the video on the top left to see what you should do while in India, and click the video on the bottom to see what you shouldn't do while in Japan.